Lucy Bear, and today I will be presenting on the rabbits in World War II. So first, a little bit of an introduction on how there even became any human experiments within the war. On May 27, 1942, SS Obergruppenführer Reinhard Heydrich was riding in an open-topped Mercedes-Benz through the streets of Czechoslovakia when a gunman opened fire, and soon after, another man set off a bomb on the right side of his car. So these two men were members of the Czechoslovakian resistance, and they were Josef Gabčík and Jan Kubis. So after this, Heydrich was rushed to local doctors, and they tried to operate him, and Dr. Karl Gebhardt, who was one of the most successful and respected doctors within the Reich at that time, was flown in to perform emergency surgery as well, but their actions were futile, and Heydrich ended up dying from an immense infection from the bombing on June 4th, 1942. So after his death, some of the most powerful men in the Reich had criticized Gebhardt for not trying to use sulfonamides or penicillin to stop the infection. Instead, he used the emergency surgery. So he was receiving complaints from Adolf Hitler himself, as well as Theo Morell, who was Hitler's personal doctor, and also Reichsführer Heinrich Himmler. So these were the reasons that they were getting on his case about it. But there was also, according to Sarah Helm in her book that she wrote about the Ravensbrück concentration camp, she said that they had pressure also coming in from the Allies, who were dropping pamphlets over enemy lines, and they were promoting these miracle drugs that they had used to save their soldiers. So there was a lot of pressure coming in on Gebhardt for not using these drugs. And so with this, Jack Morrison outlines the Nazis' next steps in his work titled Ravensbrück, Everyday Life of a Woman's Concentration Camp, and he says that within a few weeks, there was an offshoot of Gebhardt's esteemed Hohenlichen Clinic, and it was established in the Ravensbrück concentration camp to test drugs that might have been able to save Heydrich. So for the experimentation, the first guinea pigs to go through these experiments were a small group of men chosen from the Sachsenhausen camp, and they were brought to Ravensbrück at that clinic that had just been established. So according to Helm, the very first trials were very moderate. There was very little bacteria inserted to the men's legs, and they were treated with the sulfonamides, which were the drugs that they had were unsure of what the reaction would be. So although these results were inconclusive, Gebhardt was at a stopping point, and both Himmler and Hitler had not been satisfied with these experiments. So on July 22nd, they implemented the first stages of the experiment, and this was conducted on 75 mostly Polish women, and they had been brought to the camp that previous September from Lublin, Poland, as they had been arrested in relationship to the Poland resistance at that time. So these were much larger scale experimentation process, however, they still chose small groups of 6 to 10 people at a time. So a little overview of the experimentation. According to Nicholas Wachsman, Gebhardt and several other doctors, including Herta Oberhuser, had used foreign objects such as wood shavings, glass fragments, dirt, and bacteria, and inserted this into the women's legs to create the effects of gas gangrene, which was experienced by soldiers in the battlefield. And then according to the accounts of several women outlined in Helm's books, the doctor would perform these operations and then cast the woman's legs in glass dirt and then leave it for weeks to test the effects of the drugs. So there was one catch to the experiment, however. So Gebhardt, since he used the emergency surgery to save, or try it to save Heydrich, he couldn't allow these experiments to work. So a lot of the times, if he would have shown the success of the drug, he would have had to face a lot of resistance and wrath from the most powerful and cruel men in the Reich at that time. So therefore, a lot of these experiments were very harsh and very deadly for these women. There was also some experiments that the Nazis tried. These were through regeneration of bones and muscles. However, they were less common and came after the experiments with the testing of the drugs, and they were just as terrible. So according to Sarah Helm, there was at one point where many SS officials came in to review the process of the experiments, and they suggested to the point that the doctors should be shooting the legs of the young woman to get the full effects of the bone and muscle regeneration. So the doctors did not follow through with this process. However, there was terrible methods for breaking these bones, and these experiments were just really, truly awful. So although that sounds pretty terrible, the reason I'm presenting is not to show you all of this, but to show you what came, the good that came from it. So I wanted to talk about both the community and the courage of these young women as they were going through this experimentation. And they came away with, like I said, incredible courage and community. So it all started with one of the rabbits who were experimented on, and her name was Jadwiga Kaminska. From the very first experiments, she organized both gift and food for the rest of the women who were in these experiments in the Revier at the time, which was basically like a hospital on camp. And she was once quoted from Helm's book to have said anything to keep their spirits up, and that's really what she meant, because during this time, that's what the women needed as they were being experimented on and going through this awful process. So these donations came across from the camp in all different blocks and from different people of different cultures. And this was donations of bread rations, apples. There was at one point, they said, a goat carved from a toothbrush, blankets and underwear as well. So they really created that community that cared for each other. And this is also seen, lastly, when the SS start to put out an order to execute the rabbits towards the end of the war, where they're really getting desperate and want to basically cover their tracks and show that they had never done this. So during that morning's roll call, they had called the numbers, the prisoner numbers that the rabbits would have had at that time, which were from the 7,000s block. And however, there was such a strong community rallying around the rabbits that they were tipped off the night before and were able to stay in their blocks and resist the SS executions. And also, they had spread this news to people that were in charge of the electricity and the lights throughout the camp. So they also had cut all of the lights that morning, and there was much more problem than the SS had originally expected. So therefore, they did not go through with those executions at that point. And that really just shows like a really strong community around these, during this awful time around these young women. And lastly, here are my sources. Thank you.